Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 15th of 2020, well, it is titled Great Conjunction, Saturn and Jupiter Converge. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image looking out at the skyline here and looking at the position of Saturn and Jupiter over the course of 2 months from November the 1st of 2020 till December the 31st. So we can see the relative positioning of the two. And what we note is if we start off on November 1st, we see that Jupiter and Saturn are relatively far apart. Jupiter is the brighter object to the right hand side, and Saturn is the fainter object to the left. And as we look through, we see that every 10 days, they're getting closer and closer together, so that by December 1st, they're more than twice as close as they were on November the 1st. Then on December the 11th, we see them very close together towards the middle of the image. And now we are at December 15th, which would be right in between the next two, getting very close together. And we can see on December 21st, the two will be as close together as they have been since the 1600s. And in fact, 1623 was the last time that the two planets passed this close together. Now, they do pass close together about every 20 years just because of the nature of their orbits. But to get them this precisely lined up happens in a much more rare instances. And we can also see the last image as they fade into the horizon there, into the glow after sunset, that we now see that Jupiter is on the left hand side and that Saturn is on the right hand side. So they have moved relative to each other, and they will start to separate again as they merge closer into the sun and slowly disappear to later reemerge in the morning sky next year. So this is something you have to look forward to. Here we're seeing what is going to happen and what they were like over November and early December, and what they will be like over the coming weeks. So a chance coming up on December the 21st, in just less than a week now, a chance to be able to see them very, very close together if you look out to the southwest just after sunset. Jupiter will be the brightest object that you see in that direction, so you're not going to be able to miss it. The only objects that are brighter are the sun and the moon, that you would easily be able to tell the difference, and the planet Venus. But Venus is still in the morning sky right now, so it will not interfere with this view or confuse you with what you're actually looking at. Now, there's a little bit of a preview of this over the coming few days. You'll actually see a thin crescent moon in this vicinity as well for a couple of days as well. So a chance to look at that. It will not occur on the 21st. By that point, the moon will have moved well off of this region. But there will be a couple days over the next day or so where you'll have a chance to see the moon, a very thin crescent moon, in this same region as well. So a chance to see a conjunction of these three objects, the moon, Jupiter, and Saturn, but especially Jupiter and Saturn on December 21st, being as close together as they have been in almost 400 years. So that was our picture of the day for December the 15th of 2020. It was titled Great Conjunction, Saturn and Jupiter Converge. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Meteor Sky. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.